Okay, we're back on our caliper. So I've got everything all cleaned up. Scrubbed out all the piston bores. Polish these down. See all the wear marks in there. It's the kind of stuff that sticks the O-rings right there. See how rough it is? A bunch of those in there. Okay, this is the fancy goop they give you. Just got my new tool here, brand new cotter pin. Looks pretty good, huh? Let's see what's in here. A lot of air. Yeah. Whatever's in here is... That's what's in there? Enough's there to do anything. Put our O-rings in there. Didn't look good fit in there, did it? Okay, where's our fancy goop out here? Ooh, that's some good stuff there. Try not to fold these when they go in there. It won't work very good if there's a big fold in there. Like that. It's twisted. Push your thumbnail under to center it. Don't use a sharp object because it might damage the O-ring. Okay, nice, nice even coat all the way around. Now for the fun part. Pushing those in. Preferably without losing anything. Like those two O-rings there. Okay, we need a installation tool. That's not the one. There's that one. That looks like the correct installation tool. So if you get a fight more than that, you're fighting it. There might be something wrong. Just gonna poke in there, wiggle around a little bit. When it centers up, it drops right in. I'm only using maybe 5 pounds pressure at most. Okay, now I'm gonna put the O-rings right here. Take the one there. We got a little magic goop left, so let's go ahead and use it to lubricate our O-rings with. If they have to slide at all, they won't tear. Alright. That's trash. It's like a race car out there. Okay, that just goes through like that. Bolts right here. Make sure it goes in flat. The other one's still in there where it belongs. So if it's not in there flat, it'd be sticking up. It's not in the right spot. I don't know how much torque on that, only a few foot-pounds, not much. Just enough to pull it in. Got only 2 or 3 foot-pounds of torque, whatever that is. Not much. Okay, let me put a little more on it now. Torque these in a little more on the bike as needed. New brake pads again. So this time the pistons are all the way in like they're supposed to be. And we know they slide real nice, so that's a plus. Leave the hairs out. high spots in there somewhere. So the pin goes in the hole. Like that. About like that. Got a spring right here that goes in there. So that one goes on top of that pad. The other pad will have to go in there and push the spring up from the other side. Pull the pin back out of the way. Shove the pin up, the pad up, and push the pin through. Line up in there, should go through. There it goes. Now you put your cotter key in there, or a new one. So we gotta keep it from rotating. Pull around at the same time. This is a stainless pin, so it's a little harder than the last one. These things are stiff. Fell off the workbench. So we got it worked in there halfway around. Part of the finger. All right, it's in there. Pads are in there. Plenty of room to put a rotor in there. There you go. See where the screw goes in the back for the bleeder. Banjo bolt goes in the front one, I guess, because it was like that on the bike. Banjo goes right there. Okay, ready for go. All right, back to the bike.